Welcome, Gemini, to your reading. I'm Scorpio Moon. Intuition bringing messages from Spirit. This reading is general and it may or may not resonate with you. Remember, roles can be reversed. Take what resonates and leave the rest. And if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, you can visit me on my website at www.scorpiomoonintuition.com. Also, I would like to introduce to you my new fragrance, Grace. This perfume is made from the scents of jasmine, Japanese cherry blossoms, honeysuckle, and more. And if you would like to purchase my latest spray, you can get $2 off by using the coupon code SPRAY. And as a token of appreciation for trying out my latest fragrance, I will gift you a lovely scented candle just for you while supplies last. Also, if you're interested in my bath bombs and bath salts, all are now on sale for 20% off by using the coupon code SALTY. And for those of you who just purchased any product from me, I will gift you a sample fragrance or two so you can test the sprays out. And with that being said, this reading is for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Cross Watcher, if you're the one watching this reading, then it may refer to you. So let's begin. If you're wearing headphones, please lower the volume. I welcome in my spirit guides and all the angels, nice and great is good. I welcome messages of love and light that bring healing and love to all. Please bless this reading. Thank you. All right, Gemini, so let me go ahead and get straight into the reading. So let's go ahead and see. Spirit, please bring forth the energy of the person that Gemini is thinking of at this time. What is coming next towards Gemini in regards to love? Who is the person that's connecting with the sign of Gemini? And Gemini, what is your energy towards this person? Who is the person that you're connecting to in regards to love? And Gemini, what is your energy towards this person? Thank you. Wow, we have happy, happy. So overall, your person is happy, right? I see that, you know, they've made a decision about a past, maybe a past love, and they're quite happy. And they know that time is ticking, okay? So I really feel like your person really wants to work on a connection with you. And they're really happy, okay? There's time that has passed. I really feel like your person may come to you between now and possibly maybe, I want to say October-ish, okay? That's the feel I'm getting. They're tired of working, and I feel like now this person really wants to come forward towards you. They've really been thinking a lot about you, maybe because it's your birthday, okay, for some. And I really feel that your person would like to extend like an offer, okay, or just a hello, because a lot of time has passed and they want to wish you a happy birthday. That's another thing I'm also getting. Wow. So let's see what else with you. We have a leg up. So maybe you're willing to put a giving hand or leg up, right? Either towards your love interest or towards people in general. I really feel like Gemini, right now, you're in the vibration of helping other people. This could be at work. This could be, in your community, in your home. Take it as it resonates. And towards your person, we have to be fair. So what I'm feeling, Gemini, is that you want to be fair towards your person. There is some time that has passed between you and this individual. This person has changed. Now they're in a higher vibration. They're feeling really happy, and I feel like they're happy to maybe extend an offer or express their gratitude towards you. I really feel, honestly, it's a happy birthday wish. Okay, so if your person didn't wish you a happy birthday, just know that they're thinking of it, okay, because they know that time has passed, and they're just in good spirits. So let's see what else. Spirit, please reveal to me what is the underlying energy of the person that's connecting with the sign of Gemini? What is the underlying energy, please, Spirit, of the person that's connecting with the sign of Gemini? Who is connecting with the sign of Gemini? Thank you, Spirit. Wow, your person has big dreams. They're happy and they're a dreamer. Now, for some, I really feel like you're connecting with the Pisces, because Pisces is known to have dreams, okay? And also, maybe your person is also getting out of a commitment and time is ticking. So, Gemini, whoever that you're connecting with, either they were in a relationship or a situationship with a karmic person, they know that time is ticking. Okay, this has something to do with the third party. Now that your person is happy, they're thinking of having big dreams. Okay, this is actually really good energy. So either your person may or may not be communicating with you, but I definitely feel that even remote, they're actually very happy right now. Okay, and they do know that a lot of time has passed and they're trying to get out of a commitment so that they can move forward. So your person is very airy, very dreamy. They have goals in mind. Okay, that's what I'm sensing. You know, right now they feel like they can't have this fresh new start until they get out of a previous commitment. Okay. And with you, you have a conclusion. So Gemini, I really feel that you have concluded that you need to possibly, you know, give a helping hand, maybe, you know, extend an offer, maybe work on a situation, possibly let your person know that it's okay, you know, if, you know, you want this particular individual to approach you. But I really feel like you and this person have been in separation for some time. I really don't feel that you've been communicating with this person. Okay, but if you guys have been communicating with one another, I really feel that your person was afraid of commitment and a lot of time has passed and, you know, they have big dreams. They want to be happy, you know, and you've concluded that you want to be fair. Okay, you know, you're thinking about your self-worth. So you're thinking about, you know, are you worthy of, you know, receiving this person back into your life? Are you worthy of something more? I really feel like, Gemini, you're really open to any kind of experience, whether it being from this particular person or any new one that comes along. That's my true feeling on this. So I feel that, Gemini, your eyes are wide open. You're not limited to this past person. This past person, I feel like, is slowly getting out of a karmic relationship. So, honestly, it feels that they haven't released this commitment that they're in. I feel like it's fresh. You know, if they actually got off a commitment, but for some, maybe they didn't offer a commitment to you for such a long time, and maybe they don't want to stay in a commitment, and they have dreams, maybe they have aspirations, or, you know, they want to, you know, go on a different path, and I feel like you're okay with that. Let's see what else. Spirit, please reveal to me, what is the energy of this person that Gemini is connecting with? And let me fix my mic because I think it's sliding down. I think that's, we'll find out. Because if the mic keeps going down and down and down, that means it's sliding down. So Spirit, please reveal to me, what is your person's energy? And if the karmic energy wants to come through, please reveal to me the karmic energy. But what is this person's energy towards you at this time? Please give me clarity and insight of this person's true intentions towards my lovely Gemini. And Gemini, if your energy shows up, then please reveal to me What is the whole situation and you dealing with this individual at this time? Thank you. Wow. Okay, so third party situation right off the bat, and I really feel like your person, they have a lot of regret. Okay, they're not taking any offers right now. I feel like, you know, even if you were to give them an offer, they're probably going to refuse it. If the karmic was giving offers, they're refusing the karmic. They're just not happy. Okay, that's why they want to be happy with this happy card. They have dreams. Maybe they're actually thinking that maybe what you have to offer and what this karmic has to offer isn't what this person wants. So I really feel like at this time they want to work on their self-worth. Are they worthy to receive, you know, this cup from you? You know, I really feel like this person has pushed you away in the past, and they don't know if, you know, taking your cup is actually the best thing to do. So I honestly feel like your person is doing some deep reflection. Now, they do want to move away from a past connection, which is this commitment. Time is ticking from what I can see. And they, at that point, that is when they want to offer you an apology or their feelings. Okay, so I really feel that, you know, they want to do things right from what I can feel. And, you know, I feel that at some point they were really guarded or really defensive. And they were really stingy, not really offering you the time of day, right? And also, I see that maybe they didn't win out of a situation. Now they want to reconcile with you. So I honestly feel like your person really wants to come back, you know, even though that a lot of time has passed. They do want to make things up with you, okay? I really feel like whoever your person is, they're coming in matured. Okay, because they were immature in the past of not really offering you their feelings, and they weren't really giving towards you, so there was no balance. I really feel like Gemini, you were really giving towards this person. This person could have taken from you, but they didn't really reciprocate that energy back. That's what I'm getting. And now they're balancing out their feelings. Now they want to come back and test the waters. I feel that this was divinely guided from universe, because their ego and pride got in the way of the connection to return, you know. And I also feel like they don't want to argue. They don't want to include any kind of external circumstances, because this person knows that you truly did make them happy. I feel like at one point, okay, before the separation that you had, both of you felt as if you could have generally would have been happy together as a family with children. Okay, another thing I'm also saying is that you could be dealing with an Aries. They were very cold, very calculated, and they wanted to be in control. And now, you know, they're looking at their options. They're trying to see, okay, this person does have big dreams. You know, they want to choose happiness. Okay, whatever reason, for whatever reason, okay, something happened between you and this person in the past where now they are actually getting out of a commitment, and a lot of time has passed, and now they're thinking, what are their next steps? Because ultimately they had their heart blocked, their mind blocked. They couldn't make a decision to offer you something sustainable in the physical. And what I'm getting is that, you know, they're actually looking towards getting a divorce, you know. I really feel like, you know, in order for them to actually give you something properly, they have to go through this energy. And wow, this is you. So first things first, they're trying to get out of a commitment, okay, with possibly a karmic situation, you know, because justice was not served. Okay, so from what I'm feeling, this is going to take some time. And now your person is being divinely guided to come forward towards you. Okay. Right now, they're not very clear on how to communicate this, that they've walked away from a situation that wasn't fulfilling. and they're not happy, okay? And I really feel that now they want to come back. They want to speak their truth. They possibly want to tell you that they want to have something more committal towards you. And you could be dealing with a Taurus or maybe a water sign. Now your person is matured and leveled up. Now they want to offer their cup. Okay, this is really beautiful, and you could be dealing with the Virgo. They've thought about this a lot. Okay, they really did, and now they want a brand new beginning. So Gemini, this is actually really beautiful energy. Okay, I really feel like when you release expectations from outcomes and you know your self-worth, you're going to be fair, okay? Your person wants to come back. A lot of time has passed. They're actually getting out of a commitment. You've come to a conclusion that you have to give a leg up, okay? You know, and not be so rigid or put a wall up against this person. I really feel like now they have big dreams, and they really want to be happy. They wish that you could be happy, you know, regardless if this person makes it back into your life. I feel like this person is now more genuine and sincere, but because of a third party situation that actually got in the way of this connection, okay, that's why they're coming off as, you know, kind of like to themselves. But it's because it's third party. So I feel like your person has learned a lesson from dealing with karmic relationships, and they have changed. Okay, that's actually a really good sign. So let's see. So I see here the Page of Pentacles in reverse, the Five of Cups in reverse, Death in reverse, and the Hangman in reverse. So what I'm getting with this is that your person feels like they can't offer you much right now. They feel like, okay, there was already an ending, but they know that energetically it's not completely over. They've become illumined or awakened towards the situation that it's time to communicate. So I really feel that if you haven't received communication, especially on your birthday, okay, your person is really thinking about it. Now, mind you, as I'm recording this, it is the 17th of June. And on the 22nd, that's when Mercury goes direct. I really feel like that could be within 8 days. That's another week from now, okay? Where your person will actually have the energy to actually reach out and contact you, okay? In the heart, they feel like they're not good enough. Okay, you guys are in separation, and they really now want to work on the connection with you. Wow, for reunion. So your person has reunion in mind. They want to tell you that they want to get together. They want to offer you something more stable. Okay, they were just overthinking the situation, and it wasn't really good. But I see that your person's true wish is to, you know, kind of work things out. They don't want to be alone. They want to, you know, come forward towards you. But like I said, even if you told this person no, they're going to accept it anyways, because at least they tried. They've come matured. They want to have an adult conversation when they have this next form of contact with you, from what I can see. And if you don't take it, it's okay, because I really feel like this person knows that they did you wrong in the past, and they just want to like kind of close out a cycle, maybe refresh like a new beginning, because I definitely see that they have the intent of wanting to have a reunion. But you have free will to choose, Gemini, if you want this or not. And I see that is what this person wishes for. But, you know, obviously it's up to you. And they know that you are their destiny, okay? This all has to do with divine timing. For some, okay, I'm seeing 9 months. It could be September, okay? I also saw October. So you could be dealing with maybe a Libra, maybe a Virgo, okay? Because I did see Virgo energies in this reading also. So that's what I'm getting. So let me know, guys. So let's see. What are the messages that your person would like to say towards you at this time? What are the messages that your person would like to say towards you at this time? What are the messages, please, Spirit? I'm more affected than you know. I feel badly for the way that I treated you. You didn't deserve that. I feel like that's one of the conversations or the topics that this person would like to say to you when they come back. Your beauty still moves me, okay? Or your handsomeness. Take it as it resonates, guys. Please don't take what happened personally. It's not you, it's me. So they're taking accountability for their actions. They know that, they were the ones that actually sabotaged the connection. That's what I'm getting, okay? And final message, you feel like home to me. So your person is coming in very sincere. I feel like they're letting down their walls and they're being more expressive, okay? Being more honest and truthful, because I really feel like now your person is coming in mature. They haven't come to you like this in some time, and you've kind of noticed once you get this level of contact or communication from your person that they have come in change, and you're going to be pleasantly surprised. I think it's going to be a refreshing energy, and let me know, okay? So let me go ahead and close out this reading and see what is the final guidance message that you need to know. So if this reading has been resonating with you, this is your guidance message, and if the cross watcher is watching, this could also be for you. So let's see, spirit, what is the message that wants to come through for my lovely Gemini? Am I focused on what I want most? Let's see. One reason so few of us achieve what we truly want is that we never direct our focus. We never concentrate our power. Most people dab their way through life, never deciding to master anything in particular. Today's soul action. What you focus on grows. Today, ask yourself, is my life a reflection of my values, or do I need to make adjustments, prioritize? So your person is making changes. I feel like they're prioritizing, you know, what their needs, wants, and desires are. Not being really too selfish, but really, including what? Their big dreams, being happy, getting out of a commitment that they feel like, you know, that they're not resonating with. They know that a lot of time has passed, and they know that it's up to them if they want to get out of a karmic situation so they can make amends with you. And that's what I'm getting, guys. Okay, what are they focused on, and what did they want most? And if they really want you, I feel like they're actually ready to take action. But honestly, guys, I feel like they're thinking of it now, and within another week you could receive contact from your person. But just know this contact will come out of nowhere. This is something that you were not planning on, okay? That's what I'm getting. So I really hope that this reading was helpful. Let me know. Thank you all for all your comments, your likes, your shares, and subscribes. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. I provide daily guidance messages here for the collective. And if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, you can visit me on my website. It's www.scorpiomoonintuition.com. And you can also follow me on IG as Scorpio Moon Intuition. I hope y'all have a lovely day, and I will see you next time. Bye bye. Thank you for visiting my channel. Before we begin, I would like to share what I have in store for you. Me, Grace. Grace is my latest fragrance that I have created. It was made with a special subscriber in mind, and I named this scent after her. This lovely fragrance is made from jasmine, Japanese cherry blossoms, honeysuckle, and more. And if you'd like to purchase my latest spray, you can get $2 off by using the coupon code SPRAY. If you're interested in my intention sprays, attraction, and twin flames, you can use the same coupon to get $2 off from those as well. And as a token of appreciation for trying out my latest fragrance, I will gift you a lovely scented candle just for you while supplies last. Also, my bath bombs and bath salts are all on sale. You can use the coupon code SALTY and get 20% off. And for those of you who just purchased any product from me, such as jewelry, I will give you a sample fragrance or two so you can test the sprays out. And finally, you can get 40% off on all teas on my website. I have a detox and cleanse tea that helps burn belly fat and suppresses your appetite, improves skin appearance, and reduce bloating. Try it today by using the coupon code FOXY40. You can visit my online store at www.scorpiomoonintuition.com to purchase products or to book a reading. Thanks for watching.